Hey guys, and welcome back to Auction Not Included, Klei's amazing space colony simulator extraordinaire. We are playing the Spaced Out DLC. My name is Twitchi and we are on the LV426 with the cast of Alien, Aliens, Alien 3, and a few extras thrown in just because I like to put my viewers in there. Last time we went through and we made ourselves a food source. Is there a sustainable food source? I'm not entirely sure. It's giving me warnings over here, but you know, we are doing okay. The big problems that I see on the go right now is, one, we seem to be tied to the single asteroid. We want to change that. I want to change that. You guys want to go see another place? Look, we got a whole new world just over here. But another thing that I feel is getting a little bit out of hand is the carbon dioxide down here. Look at this. This is horrible. We're now over here. So we... Excuse me about that. We can quite easily combine, like try and dig all the way through here and combine these all up into one area and maybe use this entirely useless carbon skimmer over here and hook it up to the system. I would also like to upgrade these hydroponic sets, try and make my way up this ladder and across over here, and then maybe we'll find a project worthy of our time after all of that. And I'm gonna do it straight away. We're gonna set up some pipes over here. We're gonna start getting ready to upgrade our farms over here up to hydroponics. A lot of them are done, but a lot of them are not. What type of liquid do you use? This guy doesn't even need any liquid. Let's rip these pipes down. Okay, as I said, we need to dig, through here looks pretty good. We'll let all our gases mix and mingle, and then maybe somewhere down under here. Let's get these sweet tools loose. Oh, look, we've even got a sweet tool egg down here. I think we will just go ahead. I mean, do we want to dig all the way up to this and then like that? Does that look like a good area to live in? I think it is. We're going to put this area like this, and I'm going to come in, and I'm just going to throw down a few things. Now, are we going to just pump our water back here? Do we actually need polluted water for anything? We could pump it down into this one. That might be a winner. Yes. Yeah, I'm going to pump my polluted water down there. Let's do it. Okay, so we need a carbon skimmer. We also need to figure out how to get power down here, but we'll figure that out on the way. We're going to take a liquid pipe, and we're going to take the input here. We want to get some nice fresh water. Look, it comes from over there. We can bring it down this way. We'll get a little split going on here, and this is going to make sure that we can actually get the carbon flowing through the area, and then come down this side of the major pathway we have here, the up and down, the vertical thoroughfare. That's what I want to call it, the vertical thoroughfare. Now, I could just hook it up to my plants and let the plants take it. In fact, we could make it so that this indeed has priority, but I'm not going to do that. What we're going to do is we're going to pump it into this pump, this pool over here, and using the wonders of the bridge, we're going to let the... What is this thing? The sludge press. I could remember the name, honestly. We're going to let the sludge press take priority on its output because it also produces polluted water, and we want to make sure that it gets its way out. Though it looks like it can't do any polluted mud to polluted dirt and water. That's a shame. No more polluted mud. I mean, there's loads around, I'm sure. Well, maybe not. Maybe not. Here's some polluted mud. Okay. Power. How are we going to get power down here? I think there's only really one way to do it. And as much as it kind of hurts, I'm going to put down a battery and I'm going to put down a manual generator. At some point very soon, we will find our way maybe to the coal generator, maybe to the wood burner. We're going to have to try and find ourselves some better materials there. Maybe even get the hydrogen generation underway. Obviously, we're making a little bit of hydrogen power here. And it is kind of helping us draw out the system, but it's not much and it's not great. I mean, look at the flow. I don't believe we've even got like that much excess hydrogen on the go. We are kind of pumping these out as quick as possible. This ideally shouldn't be max gas pressure at all, but it turns out that it is. So we're possibly losing a little bit of time there. Of course, the fact that we have to clean our water before it goes through the system causing us some troubles. Oh, yes, these guys. Are they doing it? 60 and 20. I mean, these guys are getting drained because we've not been feeding them. Also, they're a little bit overcrowded. I think we can fix that. I think the overcrowding issue is a much easier fix than any of the other problems we have to worry about. But the biggest problem is these guys eat metal ores. And I don't want to feed them my metal ore. It just seems like a bad idea, you know? Maybe I'm crazy, but it feels like a valuable resource to me. I mean, do you reckon we could, like, get them breeding fast enough that they can turn over and keep providing us more power? I don't know. I kind of doubt it, to be honest, but we'll find out. Okay, we got a little bit of a problem down here. We got a pug slug. He's been going around and eating all the copper that we've got down the bottom. And it turns out Ripley's skills are not high enough, are not high enough to bring them over straight away to get this. So we're going to just force the issue, shall we say. It's always nice when your only builder takes the side job as their main one, right? Okay, we got 4 starving puglets now. No, slug plugs. The puglets are the little ones. We are giving power, though, so that's pretty good. So this is going up slowly but surely. We're not drawing any, like, light power yet, so that could be better. Oh, over here I want to put a light because that'll mean this manual generator gets done quicker. Let's do that. So the ceiling lights, lights of any description for that matter, will double the speed of any job that has a yellow bar underneath it. I don't know whether this has a yellow bar underneath it now that I've done this, but you know, whatever, let's do it. Let's let this guy have a nice... Ah, this is already very nearly overpowered. Let's use this one instead. Let's see if that does the magic that we want it to. We should do the same over here, really, with the research. Okay, so he does have the light, the lit workspace buff. It does say his speed is up 15%. Whether that means the batteries are charging faster, I just don't know. Okay, 2 light sources are in place. Now, hopefully, Hicks is, yes, coming along to do the water line for the carbon skimmer. Of course, the reason we have the carbon skimmer all the way down here, just for those of you that don't know, carbon dioxide is a much, much heavier gas than all of the other gases that we have around. You can see that the oxygen is kind of just floating up here and the carbon dioxide very much sinking down. And if we pop a hole through here, it will continue to sink all the way down to the lowest point, which is here at the moment. This is probably a temporary situation. I could definitely see us having a different way of dealing with carbon down here. Hello, we've got a new biome. Oh, obsidian, nice. We've got a new biome boundary down here, though. That's really cool. The fact that there's like 40 degrees down here is not amazing. Look, it gets down to like 60. There's a 600 here. Oh man, it's warm on the other side of that. Also, in the space of like 2 days, 3 days, something like that, we've gone from 6 to 41,000 calories. I think we're doing all right to click on here and go, hey, can I choose blueprint? Okay, I think we're gonna go with this guy here. This one's gonna be Honza. Yes, at the end of the holiday periods this year, Honza got a hold of me and went, thanks very much for making these. Could I possibly have a dupe? And I was like, you know you can. We need a new indoor guy, so there we go. Hopefully we'll have enough food to get through. Let's just watch these numbers, shall we? Okay, let's have a look at Honza here. Let's see what they're good at. A bit of grilling or a bit of doctor. I think we're going to go for the doctor at the moment. Maybe we'll make ourselves a little bit of a med station somewhere. That might... Oh, hello. You're new. That might do well for us. You never know. Yeah, never know. Oh, I'd also like to check this colony achievement, wouldn't I? This has been going since the beginning of the episode. I have no idea what it's for. Let's have a look. Red light, green light. Automate a building using sensors. Yeah, we did that trying to get our water nice and warm over here. All right, cool. Because, of course, this slush, guys, are coming out of minus 10 degrees, and we don't want to be getting minus 10 degree normal water because that's ice. Oh, we've broken a raw egg. Oh, no. We've swept up some eggs. Let's copy those settings across and get rid of those. Oh, no. Who knows what animal we've driven to extinction by doing that. It could be any. Not loving the fact that we have halved our calories in another 2 days. This might be a problem. Okay, we have most of the system in place now. We just need an outflow. That's all it is. Just somewhere for all the stuff to leave from. Oh, look, the liquid's going in there. That's nice. Oh, look at the sweet little larva. He's got like much more green on the go. Tiny little shell on top. Oh, that's cool. That's really cool. Anyway, by the looks of it, we only have this one bit of pipe left to go. Let's see who's working on it. Jonesy, you're not a Hicks. Okay, fine. This is good. Where are you even bringing the stuff from? All the way over this way. I wonder if he bought it from this pile of rubbish over here. It could well be, but no one's actually going to be making it at the moment. That's, of course, because Jonesy doesn't actually have any building skills. Hicks, the man himself, does. He's going to make his way down there. Of course, we might actually need to open this up just a little bit further than we have so far, because eventually we're going to be wanting to run quite a lot of stuff up there. Maybe we'll duplicate another ladder out or something like that. But there we go. The system should be underway. As you can see, we've got some liquid, some water going in, some polluted water coming out. Unfortunately, we can't quite tell right now that the carbon dioxide is being reduced. I mean, I suppose we can. Look at those numbers there. That's great. But that's because all the carbon dioxide is coming down this way, and we just got to wait for the levels to drop. And I think this is the side we're going to notice first.
Oh,
Well, that's mildly awkward. The cloud of oxygen down the bottom edge here has actually expanded out. We're going to have to wait for it to go up. As you can see, bits are trying and the carbon dioxide is coming back, but it's going to take time. This is one of the things. Diffusion, it's not the fastest thing, especially when it's only going through a too wide gap. Oh, hey, look what's going on over here. We're going to have to deal with all this water somehow. We're going to have to try and decant, especially like this water under here as well. We're going to have to try and pick it up and pop it into there. Maybe even desalinate, pollute, and then we can turn it into oxygen. Yeah, that sounds great. Anyway, with all the things that I said we needed to take care of taken care of, let's start climbing our way back up here. I wanna see what this thing is over here. This is new. This is amazing. Supply teleporter output. Where's the input? Okay, so we're really, really close here. I think we're gonna be able to make it in one go. Unfortunately, it took like 2 days to dig up this way. And I'm wondering what we wanna do through this try point. Obviously, we've got like a whole bunch of chlorine here we don't wanna let loose, but then we've also got a whole bunch of coal down here we don't wanna let loose. Now, I think I'm gonna come up like this and then go through the abyss. Are we really gonna go through the abyss? Like, this is a bad choice, but we're gonna do it anyway. There's a lot of digging there. Oh man, we've got 90 tons of polluted dirt. I think it's gonna take a little bit longer with the composters than I imagined. Okay, so this is a teleport output, I assume. That means this is the receiver. Let's have a look. If we press F6, yeah, it's the coming out of the machine symbol. F7 also. Over this side is a solid rail. You can see that. Unfortunately, because I don't have the tech, I don't have access to the overlay for that. But that's also an output. Okay, wonderful, wonderful. Now we need to just go and find the input as well. Are we outputting from the teleport or are we outputting from the asteroid? It's hard to tell. It's really hard to tell. One of the things that I've noticed having a look around the base, I've got quite a lot of temperature building up over here. As you can see, we've got like 30 degrees in places, which is nice. That's nice and toasty. But down just below, look at this, down at 10 degrees. I can't imagine Bishop is doing very well. I should imagine he's quite cold down here. Do we have a body temperature? 37 is currently dropping. So we need to try and do something about that. I am going to do that with a loop of pipes here. Yeah, I'm just going to get some liquid to carry some temperature around with me. I've asked for a liquid bridge to come across from the water down here because having a look between polluted water and normal water, they both have the same specific heat capacity, but the water has a higher thermal conductivity. Totally hadn't forgotten the term right there. 0.6 as opposed to polluted water's 0.5. So technically it should pass the temperatures around a little bit quicker, maybe. And as soon as Hicks stops digging up here, we will go ahead and see that underway, because Hicks will be the guy who wants to build that. But as you can see, we've got the teleporter output that we've just dug our way to here. I was just coming across to see what's over here, but I'm very, very careful not to go up here and go, hey, look at this, we got the input. Okay, great. The big problem with that is there's a lot of chlorine. Oh man, there's a lot of chlorine. I don't want to drop chlorine just on our base. We've only really just got to the point where we can deal with the carbon dioxide, so introducing this new horrific gas would be quite disappointing. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to move this ladder just along a little bit, and we're going to go up almost touching space and come across this way. Yeah, that's perfect. There we go. At least one bit of abyssalite in between at all times. All right, beautiful, beautiful. Yeah, we'll have a little space there. Why not? I don't mean like space. This is space up here. I meant a little bit of volume area. I mean, we're kind of 2D, right? Oh, incidentally, food back up to 62,000. So we've gone higher than the highest point we had last time. I think that's pretty good. Do we get a nice... No, okay, so this is the only graph we get. That would be a little bit unfortunate. Can we do the seal? Let's have a look here. Yeah, it's only been tracking since then. That is very unfortunate. Well, it's not working. We're taking what was 10 degree water and we're warming it up slowly but surely. Whether this is actually having a visible impact on this area around me, I don't know. What? We just watched that liquid pipe go up by 0.1 degree. I mean, maybe it is having an impact. Hopefully it'll warm all this equipment up over here and maybe start melting some of this ice. That might be asking a little much just from a few piles of compost over here. Well, I'd like to think there's a trend in the oxygen. All right, let's go and see how Hicks is doing on the build up here. Unreachable? Why? Oh, go on, legitimately. What? Ah, this is why. Okay. An insulated tile and an undug tile means we don't have room to squeeze through. That's a little bit awkward. I was going to set this up as a temperature break, and I think actually looking at it, yeah, we should do that. Look at these fingers of blue reaching their way forward, trying to come down into my base. I ain't about it. Well, I'm also not about. Did you guys see that? I wonder what temperature we have to keep them. Shall we find out over here? Above 10 degrees. We should be fine with that, right? Yeah, we could probably do with warming the water up a little bit more. Should we set that here? Yeah, let's do that. Now I've thought about it, we might not want to do that. If we come to the polluted water, we go germs. Yeah. When this was down at more chill than it currently is, it was killing them. Let's have a look. I'm sure there's a temperature. No, not you, food poisoning. Yeah, if we keep it nice and chill, they actually die on here. Okay, we need to figure that out because small little packet of dead guys there. I think we must have swept some germy polluted water into there at some point. I didn't realize we had, but we must have. Ripley is hungry enough to be giving me warnings, despite the fact that we have 61,000 calories. I don't understand. I really don't. Anyway, up here, we've been trapping a fair bit of gases in between these doors, mostly carbon dioxide, which I'm happy to see, as it is one that does not allow the transference of heat all that well. Indeed, it looks to be stopping in its tracks right there. I will be very happy if we manage to do that. We'll keep posted on that. I'm not going to hold my breath about it. I'm sure there is going to be a little bit of temperature transfer. But what I actually want to do is melt all the ice, and then it will turn into just like, you know, your standard little area full of standard little temperatures. I've moved the ladder one further over, giving us a bit more room with the abyss light, and I've also asked for this edge to be dug down here. Even though it will take a little bit longer, I'm actually hoping that actually it won't take all that much longer, as other duplicants can come along and add materials to the build. We'll have to see how that happens. Occasionally people come along to help out, but then they have other more important stuff to do elsewhere in the base. I don't know what that is that they're doing, but it's out there somewhere. Bishop is starving as well. What is going on with this? Guys, go get your food. You know, if it wasn't for all this polluted water, I reckon we could take this ladder and connect it up with this lot. I mean, but who wants to kick these guys out of their little houses, though? Not me. I'm not that mean. So there's some very cold materials here. I want to just kind of take that one out for now and see what happens when we drop minus 60 degrees material. Oh, come on, a little bit faster than this. A little bit faster. Down and into this polluted water. How long is it going to take for this to freeze out? That's what I want to know. Will it? It's not quite as instant as I was expecting, to be honest. I was expecting like minus 60 straight into polluted water. Surely that'd be making some snow straight away. The copper is reducing its temperature, but I think everything else is just sitting there. Oh, the water's just changed over to minus 12 rather than 11.9. I don't think it's going to do what I hoped it would, though. Yeah, we've got to get all the way down to minus 20. Not a chance. Maybe if we drop some more in. I've put two little weird V shapes into my pathway here because we've got hydrogen and we've got chlorine. So the hydrogen will come along and it'll get stuck up here, and the chlorine will come along and it'll get stuck down here, hopefully meaning that neither of the two pass through here. Now, we've already got hydrogen there and we've already got polluted oxygen there. So, I'm not sure if we're going to be able to stop the hydrogen completely, but we'll just see. That should help immensely. The real question now, of course, is will Hicks get there by the end of the cycle? I think is the easy answer there, no. Ah, even with friends' help, he only got this far. Look how much dirt there is on the surface of space. Wow, I wonder where that is. What's their theory there? Well, we got access to our first bits of coal, but I'm not sure that I want to rely on this. It's quite a small amount. We could run out of just from using one generator, I'm fairly sure. Okay, so this one's got a conveyor loader, and I'm guessing the inputs for these. Yes, look at that. That's water and gases. Let's activate this. I think we need to activate it. And maybe this side as well. Yeah, beautiful. Beautiful. Hicks, of course, making sure we're nice and insulated, because look, we're making carbon dioxide from how cold it is here. Ooh. Turns out Random is the only person who has the skills. What skills do they have? Let's have a look. Random. Researching, astronomy, whip skills. Not there yet. Oh no, guys, we're running out of water. It's a great big problem. Okay, we got a little bit of a problem over here. The cool slush geyser is running out. It is currently dormant, and we have to analyze it. I was going to send randomers through the teleport devices. He's the only guy who can turn on the other side of the teleporters, but we got to wait. We got to wait for that to happen. So I think in the meantime, do you remember how I was saying, hey, if we went up with this one, we could probably meet up? I reckon we might even want to come down with this one. I'm going to put in another ladder like this, and we're going to figure out if we can, like, drain this stuff over over here somewhere. I don't know what we're going to do with it, but do with it we must.
Well, I suppose we don't really. It's just something to kill time while Random Randomers is doing his work.
Of course, at some point, we need to get down here and have a look at this cool salt slush geyser as well and see if we can't make use of that. But if I think that water sieving is a bit of a problem. God, can you imagine how much of a problem water sieving and brining is going to be? Look, we got polluted water there, so we're going to have to fill it. Send it through this system anyway. Yeah, it's going to be awkward. It's going to be really awkward. Okay, there we go. I've laid out the size of a water tank here. If we're lucky, they'll get worked on the way that I want it to. If we're unlucky, we're going to end up breaking our way through here and having a huge flood. Stay tuned. We'll find out what's going on, right? Stay tuned. I never say that. What's this guy doing here? He's just having a little break dance in the middle of nowhere. I've got a feeling he's just about to... Oh, he's falling. He keeps falling from one bit to the other. I have no idea why. Can we move him somehow? I don't think we can. I don't think we're going to be able to do anything with him. We'll have to figure it out at some point. But we're waiting for Hicks to go all the way around the outside to come back down here. And that's why we want this thoroughfare done. Oh, incidentally, this little radium pipe here, totally doing a job. You can see how this is like becoming green now. This is great. Even the manual generator has warmed up to 14 degrees. That is amazing. It was something like less than 10 around here. But yeah, we're doing well. Doing well. And speaking of doing well, Random Randomus has just done this. Oh, man. Oh, we're in trouble, guys. We're in big troubles. So we could probably pump most of this water out and up into there. We could probably collect a load of water from all sorts of places. But really, these are all short-term solutions. Are we going to be able to deal with it? I actually don't know. I actually have no idea. But one thing I do know, this teleport transmitter, I want to stick Random Randomers on there and I want to send them off. Are they coming? Are they on their way? I don't know whether this is like a high priority. Here he comes. There he goes. Beautiful. I want to send him across to the next one because we need to try and find ourselves the next area. Now, I'm assuming that this is a relatively self-sustainable base. Do we actually have to send them? We do. A teleport. Away you go. I'm assuming this is a relatively sustainable base at the moment. We'll see if we can get Random Randomers to be able to receive food from this base. That's my idea. Look, he's got nothing here. Nothing at all. If we go take a little pause and just have a look around and wonder where the teleport machine is likely to be. We've got some ways. Oh, look, we've got some food in here. What's in the nutrient bars? All right, beautiful, beautiful. But, where's the teleport? I don't know. Maybe it's down here. We're going to let Random Randomers go around and do a few diggy jobs. Can we get out there? Yeah, that looks like the way to go. Random Randomers can't dig through the abyss light. This is going to be a problem. Can we send Hicks across? Here's the question. I don't know. I actually don't know. We probably should have sent Hicks first and then Random Randomers second. If we come up to the star map here and have a little bit of a click on this guy. Hi, how you doing? Can we? No, it's going to take a while to recharge. It's a shame there's no way to speed up that recharge. Fuel is papers can found and fun. Scan the ones that look interesting. New database discovery not found. Start my new job at Gravitas. I'm well nervous. Turns out they hired a bunch of new people. I guess they're expanding. And most of them are about my age, but I'm the only one that hasn't done my doctorate. They call me Mr. Krause, and it's the worst. I have no idea where I'll find the time to do it. My PhD working a full-time job. It's the troubles of life. The troubles of life. You want to get education? Yeah, you need to find the time for it. All right, let's go back. Let's see what we can do with our boy here. Okay, he's starting to work his way through, but there is no way he's going to get through the abyss light. So how do we find, maybe coming down this side, and almost definitely coming down this side, trying to find the teleporter. This is the edge of the map. That's not great. That's not what we want. Can we deconstruct this and deconstruct that and maybe put ourselves a fresh pneumatic door up in its place? And then we'll carry on across the top, right? That's how we explore stuff. We carry on across the top. Maybe we can find a way through the abyssalite here. That would be great. And make our way down. Yeah, I'm going to come down this way and see what this is. This room here. It's tantalizing. Oh, no, we can't get through that. Okay, all right. Random Randomers, you are going to earn yourself a new skill today. I don't know exactly what you've got. You've got 4 skill points. Your morale is quite high. Can we go through hard digging? Do we have to go to super hard? We'll go all the way up to super hard. And hopefully you now have the skills that are needed. Very important to get those done. I'm going to bring this ladder down this way. Not enough materials. It's okay. You will get materials as time goes on. I don't know whether sedimentary rock is the rock to build this out on. Let's cancel that. Let's have a look. Granite, you say? Okay, let's go with that. I mean, there's none here to get going with. That's a little disappointing. All right, currently actually digging granite. That's what I'm all about. Look at that, sedimentary granite. Right, cool. Are we going to come across over here? I think we're going to come across over here and just drop our way down. All right, beautiful. Why won't he dig through this?
Oh, we're out of granite, that's why, lol. Oh, look, a pile of fresh water. Beautiful. We got a bunch of salt water around. What's this, granite? Okay. It's a bit hard to see exactly what's going on this asteroid. If we press Alt S, we can get a nice overview. Did you also know somewhere around here is the rest of the other asteroid? Was this downtime? Have we suddenly had downtime called? I mean, cool, but I really would have preferred to move on a little bit further. Let's sweep this up as well. Also, this needs to be like a supermarket already, right? Biggest job in the game, keeping the toilets flowing. You know what, I might just pop this here and be like, hey, come and fix this right now. Like, right now. I know you're busy having a food, but if we can get this bed put up and running, you can sleep. Don't you want to sleep, randomers? I think you do. So this is the beautiful... just get into bed, please. Get into bed. So this is the beautiful point in the game where we now have to start going between the two zones here, making sure that people aren't immediately dying because, you know, that... could be a bit of a problem. We seem to be making enough dirt. That's cool. We also seem to be making, I don't know, what are we doing here? Is there enough water coming through? I think I might. We're ready for a bit of a hack job here. I'm going to pop this over here because it's cold. Cold water. Need to deal with it. We're going to bring this pipe down and around here. Hopefully we can actually do so. Bring this to the ladder. Whoa. Pipe going everywhere. Bring it to the ladder. Bring it down. And then I want to pump a liquid pump down the bottom here. Something like that. We can start getting some of these liquids out of here. I think that's kind of important. Let's carry on. No, the cobalt wire, if we can. Let's carry on bringing that across and down to this. And then hopefully we can just get some liquids moving up and around. I'm not sure whether my duplicate's going to be able to get up in here, but if I do that, that should also correct for all of that. Okay, it's looking good now, right? I think it's looking good. At some point when all this gets pumped out, we're going to have to go down and under and come up here and try and... seal this back in. I noticed there is some brine. That's going to be a little bit awkward to deal with. Hopefully the pump... Let's just dig that and see if we can't get the brine falling down a little bit lower than the pump. Honestly not sure. All right, with those orders set, let's come over and see what we're doing over here. Cleaning up the floor. Okay, that's a good shout. I kind of feel like we need to move another wash basin on the other side of here, maybe move the toilet into the middle, just to make sure randomers stays clean, hygienic. Or perhaps we'll pull this door down and open up under... Yeah, let's do this instead. Look. Like this. Bam. Okay. And then we deconstruct this door as soon as you're ready for it, randomers. Thank you. We'll seal this base off and we'll come back in this way. I'm hoping that we can get this pneumatic door put up over here and move the poke shells on the other side. But we'll just have to wait and see. Still can't see what's down there, though. You know, I don't really care about the mopping. Can we just do this job, thanks? Oh, it looks like some windows are coming into being. Yes, more windows are coming into being, but are they going to be useful? Look, we got the teleporter here, and then we got so this is the receiver, that's the teleporter. What's down here? Oh, it looks like the input, so it's one of the two we need. Of course, the real question is, how many of these poke shells are we going to get trapped behind this door? I'm hoping all of them. So they drown? They don't look like they're drowned. I suppose that means none of them. Oh, this guy got stuck in the door. That's no good. Can we get randomers? Hey, man, can you do me a favor and just, like, open the door and let this guy out? No, he's just stuck there for no apparent reason. Good work, my friend. Good work. I guess we'll just let them around the base, I suppose. Oh, there's the other one. All right, great. Beautiful. How do we get to that without going through the abyss light? Over the top here? Yeah. In fact, there's actual abyss light there in places. That's not great. Okay, as days digging go, that wasn't the best. But as days exploring go, we did okay. Looks like we managed to get ourselves all the major targets that we're looking for. How we actually end up breaking into here is going to be very interesting. Obviously, with randomers having the skills that he's got, he should be able to go and do all these builds here. But I'm really worried about him running out of food and oxygen whilst kicking it around here. We got enough, what's the word that I'm looking for? Oxalite to see us through for a little while. Maybe we should mop up all these spilled liquids as well. How are we doing over here? Are we out of liquids yet? We're not out of liquids yet. Okay, this is good. This has been built though. This is good. We need to extend this ladder space over this way by the looks of it. That's fine. We can make that happen. Oh man, we need someone better at sweeping over this side. Okay, let's cancel all these mop orders. We'll deal with them later. We'll definitely deal with them later. Right now, we just need to get down to here.
That one and this one. This one's going to provide food and provide food and oxygen. This is the one that I really need. So let's kind of go through here. Let's pick a priority six. And we're going to go this way with it. Beautiful. Also creating a lot of sand. This is good, right? Salt water, minor skin irritation. Yeah, I believe. I mean, personally, whenever I climb out of the sea, I'm always like, oh, it's making me dry out. Rub it off me. And oh, it's horrible. Yeah, so I'm totally about this guy being like, no, don't leave me under salt water, please. Got a fair bit of oxygen up here. We've also got a fair bit of hydrogen and some carbon dioxide to worry about. But at the moment, I think we're going okay. Got to figure out some sort of water dumping place. Let's stop for a moment. Let's open up some, like, drop pits here that we can put some ladders over the top of. I think that'll probably be a good idea. Something like this. Let's do it. All right. So we got, like, salt vines ready to go. There's some millwood and briar bluff over here. Look, bristle blossoms. Oh, man, we need to get the bristle blossoms going back to the other place. What else we got? There's some waterweed down here. What I'm really interested in, like, are any of these buried objects hatches? I could really go for a hatch right now, you know? So it turns out this is as far as we can dig. Okay, I'm fine with that. Okay, I think we're gonna leave him here digging. This should be all fine by the end of the day. Let's go over to the yuck hill and see how we're doing. We have liquids pumping. It's being pushed down here. We're waiting for this to pick up the temperature because I'm guessing this is coming out quite cold. Liquid pipe, minus 10. Okay, polluted water, minus 14. Let's have a look. It's all just blue. I really need to get some sort of heat scale that actually scales a lot better than we currently have. So far, it's just you've got cold, you got hot, and there's really a very narrow band in between of actual color degradation. So I put down some radiant pipes of the coldest area, trying to increase the transference. I'm tempted to do the same. Let's put one there and put one there. These are the two warmest areas, as far as I can tell, like 35 and 33. Maybe we could have just kept it up there. You know what? Let's just cancel that. And hopefully this will bring us some wonderful heating effects. We're about 50% recharge on the teleporter. Okay, just gotta wait. Waiting for these also to be done. Honda's made a delivery and also going around and doing the build. This is great. Okay, so coming out the bottom here, we've got 23 degree water, and then suddenly out of nowhere, we've got 23.8, 24. Look at it warming up. All right, beautiful. Every time it goes past, I reckon it's gonna warm up just a little bit more as well. I suppose technically we've only got 27 degree stuff over here, so it might take a little. Well, no. The actual compost is 30. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. I've got a feeling we're going to get nice and warm down here. I mean, it's got 23 on the radiance, so that should be fine, right? Back to Tornano. We're through. Hey, randomers. What a great bit of timing. Just got this last piece to do here, and I want to activate that. Yeah, let's get in there and turn that on. Oh, it's taped. Takes a while, it turns out. I didn't know it was going to take so long. Okay, so that's number one done. How are we going to get down to this one? Do I build another? Ooh, we got some bedrooms. That's pretty cool. But yeah, do we try and dig down to it? Yeah, I think we're going to try and dig down to it. See this line of iron here? We're going to go up through that. It's taking him time to actually do this, by the way. Because we've only got one done. Okay, all right. Fair enough. Can't we get through here? We got some obsidian. We can't get through the obsidian. The abyssalite, no worries. Obsidian, nah. Look at all the stuff that there is. Like all this stuff down here. Let's take a dig order and just do that. I think that's probably something we're gonna do as well. Maybe even take these out like this. Yeah. So maybe an extra one. Okay, big orders all over the place here. Love it. Yeah, there's a little obsidian patch here. We're gonna work around that, and that should be fine for getting down here. Look, there's another. What is this obsidian patch? Got to watch out for that. I want to dig a tunnel through this way. Cool. And we'll carry on this ladder all the way down. Obviously, of course, when the ladder can go through the obsidian, we're gonna do so. That should give us a nice. Let's come back out here. That gives us a nice round ring road around the outside of the base. You can come down here, across, up, and back over the top. I think that's nice. That's very nice. Randomers taking care of the outhouse. Wait a minute. I'm sorry. I was just building a ladder. I was changing the materials of the ladders here so we can build them quicker. Fossil? We got some fossil already. All right, that's great. But these ladders all been changed to mafic rock because there's mafic rock all around. Oh, what can't we get through? There's obsidian there. There's obsidian. Wait, F4. Oh, look at this. All right, cool. We're going to have to take this around. Okay, so we've got this one turned on. And whilst my boy Random Randomers is going around trying his best to dig down to stuff, let's go back to Your kill. How's this one doing? Not very well. How's the pump doing? The pump is done. Oh, the pump is done. Beautiful, beautiful. So it's going through, it's warming stuff up, it's pumping out. We're getting more liquids put in there. Yeah, beautiful, beautiful. We've got 54 cycles until that comes back online. But what I really want to do is all the way up here. Where are you? This guy here. See this conductive wire? We need to hook up some sort of charge zone over here. Let's put down a battery first. A battery, a generator, and let's just hook that all up like this. Hopefully this will get done relatively quickly, especially if I pump the priority up nice and high. And then in this conveyor loader somewhere in here, edible, is that what we're looking for? We can send some bog jelly through. Randomers, he needs some food, right? He needs some food. The other thing I want to do, I want to come to the ventilation. I want to get a gas pipe. I want to go, hey, you. And we're going to start thinking about how we can move some oxygen in there. Oh, I don't know. It comes up from here. It's going to be a little bit awkward. Maybe we'll just split off an extra pipe here. Okay, I'm going to just split this pipe off here so that we spread half the oxygen to this base and half the oxygen to randomers on the other base. Of course, where this pipe goes is going to be a little bit awkward. Because this bridge isn't done yet, right? I want this to go up here. Through like that. And of course, we're going to have to put some tiles there and there to keep the seal running. This is going to be a big jump. This one's going to be a very big jump. Ooh, turns out we might need a little bit of automation on the... Wait, why are we all empty pipes? Why hasn't this fed back yet? Why hasn't this picked up yet? Why hasn't this got any power? Okay, well, we've figured out that it's down to this guy up here. Is Bishop going to go do it? Let's have a look. No, he's going to go relax first. I mean, all right, I suppose. You know one thing I need to do? I need to pop a gas vent there, grab some gas pipe out of this, and be ready to receive oxygen here. Here, of course, being on Tyranno, the sandstone world. I don't know what we want to call it. Like, this is the Terra asteroid, right? This is a Terra asteroid. This is a marshy asteroid. Yeah, we'll figure that. Oh, look at the building pipes. Go, guys, go. So back on the Terra rock, we in the rations box have only got 9.2 kilos. Thankfully, Randomers is coming down to this little area down here. Seems to be getting towards his teleport supplier input. I'm going to hit the activate button on there just so Randomers will come along and do that. But we have a little bit of a problem. If I come back over to Yuckil, the marsh rock over here, up on this one, this has been enabled. Look, no, we've got no enable button there. But I thought I had done it. Turns out I hadn't. There's no activation here. But the problem is the colony lacks anybody with a field research skill. If we come up to here, obviously Randomers, he's got it. Where is it? Field research. The 2 points in. 2 points in. I don't know if we're going to have anybody who is, like, morale enough to be able to take that type of hit. No, I really don't think so. Are we going to send Randomers back? I think we might have to send Randomers back. What do you reckon? Can we get this dug in the day? Just one day, Randomers come down and through this? Maybe. Okay, Randomers has successfully dug out a whole area in here, exposed the supply and the teleporter machine here. This is great. I guess we're just going to send him back for now. Unfortunately, we didn't quite have everything ready. It's a big shame, but we will try and figure it out elsewise. Are we just being left here? No, we're going to be left. The Randomers, off he goes. Is he going to do the job that I hope he's going to do? I don't know. We're going to follow him and see what's going on. He's going to build a gas, but this is Hicks. Where are you, man? Must have passed in the toilets and lost track of him. All right, no matters. Let's see what he's doing. Use a teleport receiver. Why are you, what, hey? Anybody else think something went a little bit wrong there? I kind of feel like something went a little bit wrong there. Anyway, Randomers, what are you doing? Coming to the compost? This is not what we want you to do. Let's get you up this way, mate. I can't up the priority on the activation. That's a little odd. Which means Randomers here is going to go around and do a whole bunch of jobs. Disinfecting, doing some harvesting, stuff like that. Okay, I suppose. There's the job. Change setting, supply teleporter input. It's so far down the list, though. We've got to flip some concrete. We've got to fabricate some fabrication supply. Where is he even getting the mud from? Who knows? Okay, let's change a few of Randomers' sayings here. I'm going to turn down his farming priority. I'm going to leave the operating. Turn down his tidying. I noticed he was doing that. Maybe the supplying as well. Yeah, we'll see. The digging's fine. All right. After a little bit of a diversion working the sludge press, Randomers appears to be on his way to do the job that I really, really wanted him to do. Oh, here we go. Turning it on. Bam. All right. It's done. It's ready to go. All of these pipes are saying they don't have enough granite, but trust, they really, really do.
Oh, we are having a little bit of trouble with Bishop here. I don't know how... The Decor minus 77. What's going on there? Average this cycle is going down. How do we make it better? How do we make it better? Has that helped? Hopefully that's helped. Not F4. What is the button I wanted here? F8. It's not really done wonders, has it? I'm going to try moving the generator out a little bit. Let's see if we can get away from all this industrial equipment. Okay, hopefully this is going to help a little bit. We've also got to find out where he's sleeping. Where is Bishop sleeping? Maybe we can up his sleeping arrangements, make him feel a little bit better. This is Bishop here. Okay, all right. Let's put down also another bit of furniture. Let's put down a... another flower pot would probably be fine, right? I don't know why it's having such trouble finding the granite. Talking of trouble finding the granite, they have finally done the pipework. Let's have a look. Let's send this through. It's going to go along this pipe and up here. It's going to take a little while, I think. Made its way up and past the incoming station. And it's slowly making its way over here. I've just realized that maybe... Oh, he did. All right, beautiful. Look, it's coming straight out. It's beautiful. Look, there we go. We are oxygenating this base. Ah, the pass-through is amazing. One more thing I want to try. One more thing. If we put that up to high priority, perhaps even come down here and try and sweep some of this bog jelly. Is it going to allow me to try and put some of this into the machine or not? I've got a feeling not, and I'll tell you why. Because looking over here, even though I can't use the overlay yet, I can't actually see any connection between this and that. If we come over here, you can see that there is a line coming in and through here. I don't know, would it actually show? Would we be able to see anything? Okay, who's wearing this snazzy suit? I want to see where it is. I want to see where it is. I'm fairly sure someone's wearing one. Is it Jonesy? All right, might be random. I'm really sorry, mate, but that snazzy suit really needs to be given over to someone. Snazzy suit, there we go. Bishop, please come and get this, mate. Please. Okay, snazzy suit on. Hopefully he's going to chill just a little bit. Okay, let's see what random is doing over here. No one wants to drop off to the to this storage yet. I've even asked them for a little bit of dirt. No one. So I think to send the materials, we're going to have to get ourselves the mechatronics research underway. If we click on the tree, it is right here. Any of this lot, this conveyor loader right here, I might even just click on that and say, with that, I am going to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you guys next time when we're going to go make use of Tonano over here. Oh, that's kind of annoying to get a screenshot. You have to stop and roll out every time. But I will see you then when we're going to do that. Bye.